Hello everybody, welcome back to some more Planet Coaster. We've got another time lapse for you, and honestly it is one of my favorite things I've built in this game, so definitely like if you guys did enjoy. I am super pumped to show you. It is fantastic. Basically we're just working on Futureland part 2, just adding some more to it, trying to make it a little bit more dense, because that's something I really wanted to get across in this. I showed you right at the beginning there, I was kind of talking over it. I did add some lights to the tunnel, just some of the little white lights along the way, and then some of the blue lights in the loop part. So it looks pretty cool. You'll see at the very end of the episode, we do another first-person point of view through the coaster. And right here, I had all this open grass area, and I want to just kind of make it a little bit of a plaza. I don't want too much of this grass everywhere, because it kind of just looks very plain. And so I'm going to make this some sort of like art installation plaza sort of thing. So we're just laying down some white roof tiles just to fill it in. And it does look a little wonky since we do have to have them at all the different angles to cover the things that aren't right perfect angles. But it doesn't look too bad, especially once we add other stuff to it. And I'm just adding a rail in here to kind of just make it separate. This isn't really meant to be an area where people go. It's like I said, it's mainly just like an art installation, something to look at, decoration, but I wanted to make it more original rather than just using some of the decorative pieces that the game has. And since we are glitching out on the walls there, it's really annoying because it wasn't originally doing that until I reloaded the world. But since it's doing that, we'll just go ahead and cover it up. Doesn't look too bad. Just putting the pillars in the outside and just finishing up the railing here. Getting that over. There you go. And I do apologize. Last episode, I uploaded it and it turns out that I was mistaken about the music I used. I thought it was licensed through Planet Coaster, but I guess I used the wrong one or something. I got a copyright strike on it, so I took the video down, took the music out, re-edited it, rendered it, and re-uploaded it the next day. So some people saw it twice. If you guys stopped by and left a comment, left something, even though you already watched it twice, thank you very much. I love that kind of support, but sorry about that. I did not mean for that to happen, naturally, so hopefully no one was too upset. But that was a good episode. Definitely wanted you guys to see it, as well as this episode. I'm having a ton of fun with the future land, something I haven't ever built yet. So there we go. We did just like a little modern art piece over there. I can say that it's okay. I went to art school. I know what modern art is, okay? And then this part over here. No, I don't. We're just building. It's something I had in mind. I wish there was actually glass in this game. Right now, this is the closest thing you have to glass. There aren't any translucent or transparent pieces in the game, unfortunately. I would love to have actual windows, because this part would look so much cooler. If they ever add that, I'm definitely coming back, editing this park, and turning this into actual glass. I wanted some sort of like greenhouse or biosphere feeling. So I wanted this large glass structure. This is basically gonna house our food and our drink areas for Futureland. And we're gonna have just kind of a path go up to the inside, basically go up to like the roof, but everything below it, very lush and jungly. And that kind of inspired me to do something else, which we may do in the next episode. Which is like, if you've ever been to Disneyland and been on the Jungle Cruise ride they have there, it's very cool. It's basically just like a slow ride just through a fake jungle air with animatronic animals. And I thought that'd be really cool to do. We can kind of try and make like a real slow coaster or a ride or something, because there are the slow push tires that can kind of push carts around, so we may try that. Because I think that'd be really cool to go really dense with the foliage and everything, and try and make some animals out of the set pieces. We'll try that out probably in the next episode, but for now we're just working on the greenhouse biosphere thing. So basically we just have a path up there, and then I'm gonna have these things just kind of floating. Well, they're floating there now. Eventually I'm gonna make them into their own building, but I put a food and drink stand out there. It's the Chief Beef and the Cosmic Cow, as they're lovingly called. Hashtag Chief Beef Belief by BT Dubs. Look at me, I'm so hip and modern with my hashtags and my blue jeans, something like that, I don't know. So just working on those. We're just building just little structures, just basically like one wide and then pretty tall and long. Well, I guess it depends on where your perspective is there, but just filling those up because they're just kind of their standalone structures inside of this one. I thought about enclosing it completely, but I kind of like just having the top open. I think we make it look a little nicer once this is fully completed, but just using the auto stack feature there, which is pretty handy. Sometimes you do misclick a little bit. Basically how it works is you build a tile and you don't have to move the mouse. If you just continue to click while auto stacking is on, it'll stack one tile on top of the other. Pretty handy. Oh man, my voice is not handling all this talking today. That's the hard part about these, because normally when I record other games, I can talk for a bit and then not talk for a bit and then I just edit that out. But for these time lapses, for the most part, I'm just talking for 22 minutes straight. Looks like this one isn't quite 22 minutes, maybe like 21:30 or something like that. It's kind of hard to tell. I'm just looking at the timeline. There we go, just adding a nice little layer out there. And I do like the views it had, so I decided to extend this path over, because it brings it right by the coaster, so I think that'd look cool both from the path to see the coaster just fly by, as well as actually see the path from the coaster. I like, one of my favorite things, it's ironic, so we built all this cool stuff this episode, one of my favorite things was the actual coaster, how it feels in the space changed a lot. We have it surrounded, you'll see at the end of this video, with all these buildings, all these structures, all these environmental objects to actually go through and play around with. It was a lot of fun building around the coaster, because that's something I've thought about in the past, like, which is easier? Do you build the coaster and then build the set pieces around it? Or do you build the set pieces and let the coaster just kind of flow through it? Like, which feels more organic and natural and which kind of goes with the environment more? So that's something I'll have to think about more. Definitely, all these points I'm bringing up in this episode, guys, they're really open for discussion. I'm always trying to figure out ways to present my builds in this game. So, yeah, open for discussion. I do notice the sides of these, you may see it a few times, the railings of the stairs are sticking out a little bit. It's kind of annoying. I didn't want to redo it. I could just add another layer of glass to the outside, and I think that'll look fine. But for now, we'll just leave it. And then just adding grass everywhere. You guys know how much I love spamming these bushes. So we're just starting with the very bottom layer of the foliage. Just some bushes and rocks. Just kind of spreading them around. It's funny because most of this you won't even be able to see from the paths. It's kind of stupid, but you know, the feeling of it's still cool. I think I actually may remove one of the layers of the walls just to make that feel a little bushier. You know, it's just the things sticking out more, because even the tops of the trees barely reach the paths. So you'll see later when we do the first person walkthrough, you can't really see the bushes that much. Going up and down the stairs is pretty cool because you can see them, but it's not too noticeable. Then I threw a bunch of lights in there, just kind of light everything up. I put them there before the trees. See, there you go. It doesn't look bad. Just kind of zooming in around there. It's kind of hard to see right now. It's because we're going through so very fast, but I like it. I think it came out pretty cool, especially when you just see the people walking around up there. I'm just adding some AC units. Gets pretty toasty in there, I imagine. Yeah, there you go. You saw the staircase sticking out of the side. And then just kind of topping it off with a nice little white railing or molding or whatever it is. I'm not an architect, but overall, I think the building came out pretty good. That's something I'm trying to do a lot more in this Futureland, is stick to the more, or I guess the less detailed and more solid colored buildings, because in my mind that's always more modern and futuristic. There we go, and for the most part, that's done. I'm just adding a nice little Chief Beef sign, and a Cosmic Cow. There you go, looking good. So now people know where it is. Well, I guess they would have to know, because you can't really see the signs from the main street. There we go, just those little things already filled out the area quite a bit. And now we're going to cut over to, I guess it's nighttime now. I wanted to add another ride. This build, I'm not super happy with. I may go tweak it in the future. I wanted just a very large, modern, white-looking building. It came out okay. I'm not super happy with it. I wish I could change the color of the ride, because the red does stick out quite a bit. I would have preferred to use a different ride, but this was the best one available for us at the time. That didn't inherently have like a pirate theme or anything, but yeah, putting this path down was kind of annoying, because I did want to have this railing kind of go across there. It was interesting, but there we go, ended up doing it like that. Doesn't look too bad. I also want some new path options, that'd be great. And just taking a look over there, King Coaster was up by the Cosmic Cow and the Chief Beef just hanging out. I do love King Coaster, not as much as Chief Beef, hashtag Chief Beef Belief. But King Coaster's alright. He's better than Lockjaw. Lockjaw's a lame mascot. And I finally did see the dinosaur. I don't know the dinosaur's name, because in this game, there are four mascots. There's Lockjaw the Pirate, Planet Coaster, he's the big ball. Chief Beef, he's the walking hamburger. And the dinosaur. I don't know if the dinosaur has a name. He probably does. He's pretty cool looking. I like him. He was one of the ones that was in the original trailer for this game. With that Lady Antebellum song or whatever her name is. There we go, we're just basically encasing it in white. Again, rides are annoying because with coasters, you can actually edit the building that the ride is on, that the coaster is on, and it puts everything on a grid. It's real nice, everything's laid out perfectly. With rides, there is no building grid, so it's kind of annoying. So I kind of just have to make it up as I go and try and line things up, so it's a bit more organic in nature, and then it's hard because we're on a hill here, so things keep changing in height. And then when I'm precisely trying to move them by looking straight down, it's kind of hard to tell what height they're at. But there we go, we got the whole thing relatively encased. And then we're going to go with a little bit more of an angular design here. Well, we have to kind of get it wrapping around this ride. Or around this queue, I should say. There we go. So we kind of have like a point to the building. It looks all right, especially when I dress it up a little bit. I didn't want to do too much detailing because I did want to keep it kind of solid. This was probably my least favorite build of the Futureland. The next two we do are freaking awesome, and I can't wait because they came out so good. And I just love it, especially the last one. I think it came out really cool. I just want to get to that. Screw this building. I just want to skip over it. Dang it. And then just covering that up so we can finish the entrance, or the entryway. Just trying to get that wall nice and flush. Came out all right. And again, found another piece that wasn't at the proper height. I should do something with the top. Because the problem is, now that we're dealing with all these different pieces, just detailing is hard because you keep having to select the different builds and then it's not all on a grid, so you kind of have to lay everything out. And then every time you want to build something and then build something else on a different part, but it's a different building, you have to deselect it and select it. But that kind of worked for me because I was trying to stop myself from going overly detailed on this build. That's something I need to stop myself from doing, because in some cases, like if we're doing like the colonial style buildings or even the Western world, the highly detailed stuff is good because it was all like crudely thrown together builds and everything. But with the modern stuff, I don't want too high of a detail. I do like the flatness and the sheen, because that really reminds you of like a postmodern world and design sense, structure, things like that. Again, I don't know too much about architecture. I did take a couple art history classes in college. We did do architecture, but I didn't really pay attention because honestly, it was art history. I couldn't really make myself care very much. I don't know. Then we're just filling this in with the vitality. Every time I do this, I have to deselect it and then reselect the tile just because it is a different building. So that's kind of annoying. Sometimes you do get lucky and they do line up, so you can kind of just make a grid. There you go. So it doesn't take as long. Well, hopefully not as long. Doesn't take nearly as long as now that we're in the time-lapse, though. That's super handy. I'll say that much. I'm just covering that up. Going to get at the right height. Come on. There you go. I just wish I could change the color because I don't like the red bride. Ugh, it's kind of ugly and annoying. Then it's tossing a few windows on here. Just on the front. Just kind of making it look like it's an actual building. This tree was pissing me off, man. Look at this. I couldn't get the stupid window on the right. I should just move the freaking tree. In fact, I'm pretty sure that window is crooked. Whatever. And then just some little blue barricades. Not really barricades, just beams on the front here. Just kind of extenuate the entrance and the exit. Excuse me. I just had a big steak and egg sandwich at this breakfast place. It was awesome. We were going to have cronuts, which is like a croissant / donut. Well, they call it a desant, so it's a donut croissant. But I like croissant donut better, cronut. I don't know, desant just sounds too fancy. I like cronut better. We are getting way off topic here. Sorry. All right, now we're working on just visually interesting buildings. Nothing functional. It's not going to have a ride. It's not going to have any food or drink stands in it. Which is okay because we're the limited content of the game at this point. We don't need everything to be practical. Like a lot of things in theme parks are just there for decorations. And so even though these are like skyscrapers, or they're going to be skyscrapers, relatively large buildings, they're there still just for decoration. Because again, they sit in the environment of the rides. This is one of the things that I think made the coaster feel a lot better and a lot more like a city, because I wanted this to feel like a city. It's a futuristic city. That's the whole point. So we build this one, and then we do a little something crazy with it that I think ended up working out pretty well, because, I don't know, I like the look of it, but we'll just carry on here. I won't spoil anything right now. Delicious, delicious water. And just topping it up there, just kind of go with a, I don't know, unusual design. Didn't want it to be like a perfect looking little skyscraper. I do like how you can just take the whole thing and just kind of wiggle it around, find the nice and perfect position for it. Then just adding some white paths all the way around it, kind of feel like a, oh yeah, just kind of making it feel like a pathway. Except for the part back there where it's underground. Oops, whatever. Then just filling in some detail, just some beams going along there, and decided, okay, we'll just have those go all the way up. There you go, and did I leave those there? I thought I didn't leave those there. Oh, okay, I guess I did. I could have sworn I removed those. I guess not. Or maybe I just was thinking that I didn't actually put them on top layer. And then we have these windows. There are a bunch of different windows in the game, but most of them are like stone or wood. There's really only one modern looking one, which is the one I've been using in this area, and I used on the bottom floors there. The one I used on top, technically it's like a stone one. It doesn't look bad. It fits okay with it. I'm gonna try out some different things. Oh, some of those little I don't know what to call those. But then I decided, okay, we're gonna flatten this area out so we can actually finish it. So let's just flatten it all out. Give it its own little landmark or base. Cause that way we can actually finish all the way around it. Then it's adding a little railing all the way around it. Make it feel like it's its own thing. And then I think I did kind of cover that to make it look like a balcony. I'm not sure. I really like how these, I went later and looked around from like the very entrance of the park, and you can see these really tall buildings, and that's something I really like and thought was pretty cool. Then just adding some lights all around it, which again, copying and pasting them from the main lights on the streets. Wanted to go down to first person to kind of look up at it. See, look, that looks pretty cool. I'm liking it. And then I decided I want some more of these, so we're just going to copy and paste them. Just going to move them over there. Just kind of have one there right in between the coaster, so it kind of flies in and out of it. Another one over there. And do I end up putting... Oh, I did put that there. Okay, I wanted it right by the roller coaster rail, so you kind of just flew past it. And then, okay, it doesn't look too bad. It does not look too bad, but I didn't want to make them a little bit different, so we busted out the walls on a couple of them. Took out the blue walls and then added the white ones just to make them a little bit more different and or unique from the other ones. So I did that one. And did I do to any others? I may have done it off camera. But then I wanted another large building. And this one I'm actually really proud of. I think it came out really cool. Looks very futuristic to me. And the way I did it is actually pretty clever in my mind. I don't want to toot my own horn, but I was pretty happy with what I did. So basically I just wanted like a raised structure just on those kind of metal poles, just kind of sitting up there, and it's kind of like a pod or something. I want to do something a little bit more round, since everything we've been doing has been kind of angular, and it goes well with the angular building that we have around our future roller coaster. It kind of harkens back to that, and it's very similar, so just kind of wrapping it around. It's like a little rib cage or something for the building. Doesn't look bad. There we go. I'm like, okay, that's looking all right. Let's put this there. And then I rose up. I forgot to put the white path. There you go. Looking pretty good. So basically, I take this and I put it there. I'm like, oh, it's looking all right, but I want the big skyscrapers. But check that out. I can just copy and paste it. I can make this thing, like, infinitely tall. But I ended up just going with three. So I just take the whole thing and I copy and paste it. Take those off the top. And look at that. Look how cool that looks. I'm really proud of that. So now we got that ride kind of swinging in between the buildings. It looks fantastic. Then just building a little plaza underneath it. Just trying out some different designs, things all around it, trying to find a nice little housing for it. But look at the whole street's looking so good. I love it. Just adding some more railing down there. And I did go through off camera and added some lighting to the tops of the buildings and stuff. I forgot to record that, or I just didn't want to. I don't know. But you'll probably see that in the next episode. And then I take the Futureland entrance. Oh, I forgot to move the F over it, because the F wasn't connected. But yeah, I just took the entrance to Futureland, and I just copy and paste it to the other side. Now we have a nice little contained, a themed park of our theme park. I just love like how much more dense it's looking, how much more going on. Like, it looks so cool from atop, from walking around on the inside, especially from the coaster. You'll see that soon. And then just kind of adding some bushes everywhere. Too many bushes, remove the bushes. And there we go. Welcome to Futureland. The completed Futureland. Last time I did a walkthrough, wasn't a lot going on, but look at this. Just looking down the street, seeing those tall buildings way off in the distance, and that ride kind of going around. Ah, looks so cool. I love it. I just wish that ride was like blue and white, so it went with everything else. The red and yellow really kind of bugs me. Look at that, how the coaster just feels like it's actually fit into the area more now. And that guy just walked by with a drink. You probably got that at the Cosmic Cow. Yeah, look at them. They're all eating their little Chief Beef Burgers. That's so cool. There's the entrance to our coaster. Has the big building underneath that giant drop. Absolutely insane. And then it's just a short look into the greenhouse. The biodome sort of thing, biosphere. Yeah, it looks really nice and lush in there. Probably looks pretty cool at night. So it is kind of all visible from the actual staircase, so I like that. It's not super visible from our point of view, but I guess it's more important from the customer's point of view. But then we switch to nighttime, right on the coaster. Look at this. Just zipping by all the buildings. Oh, that's so cool. It just makes it feel so much better than just a coaster standing by itself in the middle of the field. Oh, man. Barely got stuck up there. And someone said I should add boost tracks to this. This coaster doesn't have boost tracks, and you can't add boost tracks to a loop anyway. So that wouldn't really work. Going around here, corkscrew, other corkscrew, in and out of the building. Still want to do something in there. And look at that, we just go right above that building. And the drop looks really cool now. So then I'm just trying to look around a little bit. And down we go. Look at this, with all the stuff in the outside of the background and the big shadow. Oh man, there we go. So we got the lights in there. Then we have some blue lights on the loops. Double loop right there. Shoots you right back out. Awesome. Well, that's going to be it for this episode, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed and you want to see more Planet Ghosts in the future. I'll see you next time. Bye.